So we have already discussed that there are two kinds of the mutations. One is the spontaneous mutations, which are naturally occurring inside the body of the all the microorganisms of all the organisms, and other are the induced mutations. So we will study the spontaneous mutations. First, we will see the spontaneous mutations. As we have already discussed about it, that their rates are very high, or maybe the mutations may be very low. There are about the mutations occurring, maybe it will be 10 raised power 3 or 10 raised power 4, or maybe it will be 10 raised power 1. They are very high. It all depends upon the methods of the replication and also the length of the genome of the virus. If the length of the genome of virus is big, then the mutations rate will also be very high. And similarly, the mutations rate will also be very low. So just like the human immunodeficiency virus, the HIV virus has very high rate of the mutation, and the very low mutations occurs in the herpes virus. It is also dependent upon the antigenic drift and antigenic shift. But this is the very important property of the viruses, which is because of this property, the viruses are very difficult to control, and the immune system of the host is unable to, because the immune system of the host has the memory cells. It will recognize the cells which occurs once in front of it. But the viruses are always changing their mutations, so that's why it is very, very big in the HIV virus, so it is most difficult to control it, resulting the mutations even in the cellular DNA. The reason, the mechanisms of the genome replication, the DNA-dependent RNA polymerases shows higher, as we have already studied, that the RNA-dependent RNA polymerases have the higher rate of the mutations as compared to the DNA-dependent DNA polymerases, because their DNA-dependent polymerases are more stable as compared to the RNA-dependent RNA. Do the RNA viruses have the proofreading ability? This is very important. Of course, yes, the RNA viruses have the ability, and they show the higher rates of mutations than the DNA viruses. Of course, if they have the proofreading ability, there is RNA, and RNA is just single-stranded. Sometimes there is also double-stranded, but RNA single-stranded, so it will have more tendency to be mutated as compared to DNA, which is double-stranded and which is more strong and more stable as compared to RNAs. As it's clear from the diagram given on the slides, that there is a one lagging strand and then the leading strand of the at the time of the replication, and how the there are chances of the mutations which occurs, then the DNA primers and the DNA polymerases, helical strands, all are there, and it is the process, just to show the process and how it's very easy that the mutations will occur on this part of the replication. Then the mutations are good or bad. This is very important property of the viruses, whether the mutations are good. Sometimes they are really very good for the virus point of view, because virus is able to evade the immune system of the body. But most of the time, it's not good. The mutations helps to escape the immune system, but mutations may be dangerous, deleterious. Sometimes they can delete something body from some special genetic property of the body. Due to production of the defective particles, it is very, very bad that mutations occurs. For example, we take the example of the HIV genome, which is 9.7 kilo base pairs in length. The mutation rate can be 0.9 to 9.7 mutations occurring in every genome copied. As we have already seen how the genome is going to copy itself from one to other, so it is very, 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 very controversial that 0.9 to 9.7 mutations can be occurs in every genome copied. There are some special mixtures of the molecular variants present inside the body, which is also called the quasi-species. Usually the wild type of the viruses dominates, and it will have such kind of the bodies, mostly non-infectious. They are very important in the viral infection, but most of the time are weeded, are not naturally are weeded from the viral genome. Then the reason there are different kind of the spontaneous mutations has been occurring, and what is their specification, classification. The tautomerism is based on the positioning of the hydrogen atom. If the hydrogen atom of the base pairs is changed, then it will be called the tautomerism of the mutation. Then there is the depurination. The purine base has been lost. It will be called the mutation on the basis of the depurination. Then deanimation and the hydrolysis change of the normal base to the atypical base. The deamination It is based on hydrolysis change of the normal base, and it will be changed into atypical base on the basis of the hydrolysis. Then slipped strand or mispairing, denaturation of the new strand, it will be called that slipped strand mutation. Then in the replication slipping, error during the replication process will be called as replication slipping mutation.